Chances are you are in Savita's chem class and you still don't get titration. But what's really going on that makes titration so complicated? Well, let's begin. Titration is a technique where a solution of a known concentration is used to determine the concentration of an unknown one. Let's say we have 0.1 molar of HCl and 0.1 molar of NaOH. They both respectively have one H3O and one OH, so they will neutralize nicely with the same amount. Say we have 10 milliliters of 0.1 molar HCl. We're going to drop the base, just like Nicki Minaj, 1 milliliter of NaOH to the HCl and calculate the pH of the solution. Then we're going to add another 1 milliliter of NaOH and calculate the pH again. We're going to do this until the amount of NaOH becomes 20 milliliter. Let's do an example of this pH calculation. First, we must calculate the number of moles, in which we will use N equals CV. So, the initial number of moles of HCl will be N of HCl will equal to 0.1 molar times 10.0 milliliter, which will equal to 0.001 moles. This is then followed by calculating the number of moles of NaOH, in which N of NaOH is equal to 0.1 molar times 1 milliliter, which will equal to 0.0001 moles. So, following this, we must calculate how much moles of HCl remain, which is calculated through N moles of HCl remaining is equal to 0.001 moles minus 0.0001 moles, which will equal to 0.0009 moles. Now that we have the number of moles remaining, the concentration can be found through C of HCl is equal to N over V, which is equal to 0.0009 moles over 0.011 liters, which is equal to 0.0818 molar. Finally, we can receive the pH by using the concentration of HCl, as it corresponds with H3O as a result of being monoproduct. So, the pH is equal to the negative log of 0.0818 molar, which will equal to 1.087. If we follow the same methodology for all different volumes of NaOH, the pH chart comes to look like this. You would think that if we were to graph the gradual change in pH, it would look similar to a linear function, right? Wrong. If you were to graph the gradual change in pH, the function line would display an extremely unique shape, known as a pH curve, in which there is a steady small increase at the beginning, and suddenly, the pH will jump drastically to then steady again. This shape is as a result of the logarithmic scale of pH. If you were to calculate the pH using the same logarithmic equation used above, pH equals negative log concentration, then the numbers will be drastically different as a result of the nature of logarithms. Basically, logarithms, when the amount of base multiplies by a factor of 10, the pH will increase by 1. Therefore, there needs to be a huge increase in the amount of base for the pH to have a noticeable change. So, a small increase in NaOH won't really show in the graph, but when the amount of base finally equates to the amount of acid, the solution is neutral and will show a drastic change. Therefore, unless the pH is exactly 7 or very close to it, it's either going to be very acidic or very basic.
Now that we have a pH curve, we are able to understand some of the terminology that is associated with it. Let's start off with the equivalence point, or the point in which there is the same amount of moles of the acid and the base. Or in other words, it's the point where the pH is 7. So in experimental terms, the equivalence point is related to the endpoint, or where the indicator changes, in which you need to have a pretty basic solution or to reach this endpoint. However, the solution is always slightly acidic or basic, as there is always excess acid or base remaining. Usually when this occurs, the solution will suddenly change color due to the indicator. An indicator is a substance whose change in color shows that the endpoint has been reached. We will use phenolphthalein that changes light pink when the solution becomes basic, which is above pH of 7. Getting this light pink color might just be the trickiest part, because just like Miss Paul, she comes in for like 2 seconds and then just leaves immediately. Oh yeah, and a titrant is a solution that is being added to the substance in the original solution. Generally, the titrant will have the known concentration, and this is referred to as a standard solution. Now that we know some of the terms that are associated with titration, how does it truly work? Well, let's go through the steps of titration and perform a little experiment while we do it. Well, first things first, you have to grab all the necessary equipment and prepare them for the experiment. You must place the burette filled with the base over the beaker that has a specific volume of acid. Then, through the use of a cable, we will connect it to a computer software that will allow for the creation of a pH curve. Next, prepare this acid by placing an indicator known as
phenolphthalein
in order to show us when the acid has been titrated. Now, just like Nicki Minaj, you have to start dropping the bass slowly into the beaker as you mix it until you reach the moment in which it is light pink. And hopefully, if you did it fast enough, the software will show a steep increase from 2 to 9. Therefore, since the experimental titration graph matches the theoretical pH graph, one can see a titration does in fact happen. Now, after the experiment, several calculations can be done to determine the concentration of the acid. We have 25 milliliters solution of 0.5 molar of magnesium hydroxide, which is titrated until neutralized into a 40 milliliter sample of hydrochloric acid. What we have to find is the concentration of the hydrochloric acid. First, let us model it with a skeletal equation. Magnesium hydroxide plus hydrochloric acid turns out to be magnesium chloride and H2O. First, we must determine the moles of magnesium hydroxide in this equation. Number of moles is equal to concentration times volume. So number of moles of magnesium hydroxide is 0.5 molar times 0.025 liters. So therefore 0.0125 moles. Since magnesium hydroxide has two hydroxide ions, we must determine the moles of hydroxide as 2 times 0.0125 moles equals 0.025 moles. What we need is the concentration of HCl, so we must determine the concentration of a hydrogen ion. So basically, when the base neutralizes the acid, the number of moles of a hydroxyl ion must equal to the number of moles of hydrogen ion, so each one will neutralize the other. So therefore, the number of moles of H+ is equal to 0.025 moles. Every mole of HCl will produce 1 mole of H+, therefore, number of moles of HCl equal to number of moles of H plus is equal to 0.0250. With the number of moles of HCl, we can finally determine the concentration by using concentration is equal to number of moles over volume. Therefore, concentration of HCl is equal to 0.025 mole over 0.05 liters is equal to 0.625 molar. Now that you know how to finally tackle titration calculations, one can easily remember this calculating process by a little algorithm that we created. Buy me new clothes! Beginning with B, one must be sure to balance the equation so that way you can make sure all the stoichiometry is done correctly. After balancing comes M, or moles, where through the use of the volume and the concentration that is given for the base, one can calculate the moles through the equation of C is equal to N over V. Once you have done the moles of the base, one must realize N, or the fact that the acid is being neutralized by the base, and so the moles of the acid will be equal to the moles of the base. Finally comes C, in which once you have the moles of the acid, you can use C is equal to N over V to find the concentration. Yup, that's about it! So next time you get a titration question, just remember BMNC, or buy me new clothes.